section of the Tamil Nadu trader organizations have asked their members to stop selling popular soft drinks made by multinational companies from the 1st of March. Now, these include Coca-Cola and Pepsi products, declaring a war against international beverages. Here's what they have to say.
தமிழகத்திலே குடிநீர் தட்டுப்பாடு ஏற்பட்டு மழை வெள்ளத்தால் வந்தாலும் இன்னைக்கு குடிக்க நம்மட தண்ணி இல்லை. ஆனா சாதாரண விவசாயி சாதாரண குடிமக்கள் ஒரு 200 ஒரு 80 அடி 100 அடி போர் போட்டு தண்ணி எடுத்து குடிக்கலாம். ஆனா 3000 அடி 2000 அடி போர் போட்டு தண்ணி எடுத்து ராஜேஸ் தண்ணி போட்டு உங்களால குடிக்க முடியுமா? அந்த அளவுக்கு வசதி வாய்ப்பு எங்ககிட்ட இல்ல. ஆனா பெப்சி போன்ற குளிர்பானங்கள் சொல்ல விட்டுறேன் சொல்லிறேன் குளிர்பானங்கள் ஆயிரக்கணக்கான அடிகளை போர் போட்டு ராட்சச அடிப்படையில் தண்ணீர்களை உறிஞ்சுகின்ற பொழுது அக்கம் பக்கத்தில் உள்ள தண்ணீர்லாம் இல்லாமல் போயிடுது. இன்னைக்கு வறண்டு இருக்குன்னா தமிழகம் விவசாய பூமிகள் வறண்டு இருக்கிறது. வறட்சி மாநிலமாக அறிவிக்க வேண்டும் என்று மத்திய அரசிடத்திலே மாநில அரசு கோரிக்கை வைக்கிறது என்று சொன்னால் இதற்கு அடிப்படை காரணம் ஆதாரத்தோடு சொல்றோம் இந்த பெப்சிகோ குளிர்பானம் தான் மட்டும்தாங்க.
Shabir Ahmed now joins us with more on this story. Shabir, what's the real reason behind it? There seems to be more to it than meets the eye. There are various arguments. Some say it's because of the pesticides. And now we have this person saying that the water table of the entire state is being affected because of these companies digging borewells that are 2,000, 3,000 square feet, 3,000 feet deep.
Well, Anand, it's there are multiple reasons. And what we can understand is that the basis of going ahead and taking such a decision is the Tamil pride that was showcased at the marina and all across Tamil Nadu, and that is the reason why these traders have decided to do this. Because when I spoke to the president, he said that the kind of overwhelming support that they have received at the protest, where people were calling for boycott of Coke and Pepsi and other foreign brand drinks. So clearly that was the reason that motivated them to go ahead and take this decision. But apart from that, they have their own reasons to justify the decision that has been taken. And in fact, when I asked him that why is the traders body deciding on behalf of the people, if it should be the people who should decide what they have to drink and what they have to eat, and how can the traders body decide, he says that we are doing it for a greater good, we are doing it for the people, because for our farmers. And they have their own justification as far as how Coke is drawing waters from farming lands. So these are some of the kind of justifications that they have been giving, and there have been several protests that have happened in the past, but this time around the emotion seems to be a bit bigger, and it has caught the imagination of several groups, and that's the reason we could see that
there is a clear pattern here, Shabir. There's a clear pattern, because the angst, and it was Peter who was made the villain for the Jallikattu protests, and none of the politicians were held accountable or the administration was held accountable for the fact that Jallikattu and that ban had come to pass and nobody had said anything, and they blamed it all on Peter, saying it's the international body or an international organization that is interfering in our culture. And now that seems to have manifested on these cola brands with these multinational companies. Let's listen.